North Carolina has been covering hurricane and now tropical storm Florence all weekend long. Jim, we now know that the winds have gone, but the rain has been left behind. Give us a sense of how bad it is.
Well, it depends upon which part of the state you're in, McGraw. Here in the eastern part of North Carolina, the rain seems to have stopped, at least for now. It could return. The wind has died down substantially. That should give utility crews a chance to get out and start restoring electricity. It's still out. The power is across large sections of North and South Carolina, something like 500,000 homes and businesses without power. The western part of the state is where they're suddenly and still having a flooding threat, not only from rising rivers, but also from lakes that are rising up and threatening to breach their dams, even brand new dams. There was one that was dedicated this past January, which now is in danger of failing. And so people living downstream from that dam are being told that they need to be ready to get out fast, McGraw.
How much rain are we talking about?
In one place I saw a total was something like 32 inches of rain in one community, and it seems to have been hit especially hard. Swansboro, I believe, is the name of the place, and that may be the record. And in fact, across North Carolina, this has been the heaviest and highest rain total for any tropical storm or tropical or hurricane for the state in history.
You mentioned it still might be raining, but we all know that once the rain stops, that doesn't mean the flooding stops.
No, you're right. And especially along the rivers, the Cape Fear River, which runs along the west side of Wilmington and past several of the communities, Fayetteville and some others, it still is a major flooding threat, as are all these dams and are these lakes out there. So, yeah, just because the rain might have stopped here doesn't mean that the threat of flooding isn't gone.
Now, you're in Wilmington, North Carolina. I've heard you're actually cut off from the rest of the world.
Yeah, all weekend long, we were trying to find a way to get into or get out of Wilmington, and it just didn't exist. And we're hoping this morning that as the rain has stopped, that maybe some of those roads will have dried out enough that they'll be passable again. Obviously, the people who live here are hoping to get utility crews in to restore the electricity, but then there's just the practical matter of getting out of town.
What about the security crews going and saving people who are stuck in their homes? What do you hear about that?
Still going on. The so-called Cajun Navy has been hard at work all weekend. Other volunteers, along with the professionals and crews who have come here from all across the country, first responders with boats and equipment and manpower and experience, even if they don't know much and have never been through a hurricane, they can put those life-saving skills to work. And that's been happening hundreds of times.
Jim Ryan, ABC News correspondent in Wilmington, North Carolina. Jim, be safe. Thanks for checking in.